I'm doing a video right now where I gotta get space. I can't do my normal hugs, you know what I mean?
Really?
Destiny. Destiny. Cut it out.
Hi, I'm Carol Winter, and I'm founder of Give Space. Give Space is a kind and simple message that quickly cues others that this is my personal space boundary, and to come within it, you need to ask my permission. National Personal Space Day is November 30th, and it's the perfect time for us to take pause and think about how we do interact with other people.
We're gonna be giving some BuzzFeeders some Give Space clothing to wear for the day.
Ari asked me to be in this video where I go for a full day with asking people to give me space. She knew this was gonna be a struggle for me because I love touching people. Like, when I see somebody, I wanna hug instantly.
So here I am in my Give Space hoodie. Space is really important. I'm a huge proponent of personal space. I'm certainly not a hugger at all. I will always go for the handshake first. We've all been hugged by someone or touched by someone that we have just like not wanted to be hugged by, and I never want to be that person who gave someone a hug that didn't want a hug. I'm really excited to wear this. Feeling cool.
Yeah, so I mean, I feel like I look pretty good. Yeah, don't judge me, bro.
No, you look good.
Okay, cool. This is gonna be really tough. I really hope that I can make it through this whole day without like losing it, cause yeah, I'm not used to this. So we'll see what happens. I don't know what to expect. I'm kinda nervous. Ah!
My mom was immunocompromised for 40 years and she was very beautiful and people loved to hug and kiss on her. And she was also Southern, and in the South, they often even kissed her on the mouth. So I would beg her, please, when you're gonna go to bridge tonight, Mom, or you're gonna go to church, how about we not let people love on you so much? Because she would get sick again. And then we'd end up back in the hospital. And so it was cyclical. And I really felt threatened by it, that she was going to get sick and, you know, I would lose her. And then I had a friend who had a mastectomy. And I spent the night with her, and the surgeon came in and said, Julia, no hugs for 2 weeks. And she's like gone dilaudid, and okay. So we went out in the hall, and this orderly recognized her. She's a surgeon there. Picked her up and bear hugged her. And I yelped, and I asked him, just do something, please. Just like make a necklace for her or something that tells the people, I love you, but I can't hug you. 2 weeks later, I went to my mom, and I said, I am going to quit my job. I can't. And do something about this.
So, what is this hoodie?
So this is my Give Space hoodie. And this is pretty much just a piece of clothing designed so you can pretty much just show people, like, you know, in terms of personal touch, like, hey, just like, you kind of tap the peach.
Oh my gosh.
And you're like, hey, just, I love ya, but like, I need my space. And then people are like, oh, sure, gotcha.
As someone who loves her personal space, I'm into that.
I love that.
So yeah, it's just like a little kind of like, hey, not today.
Yeah, thanks. Usually you would just tell me.
Right.
Yeah, but this is cute. Not everyone has that kind of connection, so I get it.
This poncho is incredible. What's the motivation?
Space.
I love it. I just want to give him some space.
Thank you. People are starting to get it.
I didn't read it before, but it says it in different languages.
Yes. And you know my usual thing.
Yes. He's a hugger, ladies and gentlemen.
So far, so good. I'm really cozy. People are respecting my space.
Give Space is designed for people who have just gotten out of surgery, or people who have weak immune systems, which can make them susceptible to illness if they're exposed to germs, or anyone who's simply sensitive to touch. Do you know that there's over 4 million deliveries in the US each year? And that's a lot of belly rubs, unsolicited. And there's 5 million people with PTSD, and 1 in 59 children have autism. So there is so much application.
Day's been going fine. Like, I'm not like a huge touchy person anyway. So anyone who knows me, it's not like people are coming up to me and like giving me hugs all the time. So I can't say that anything's kind of like abnormal in the workspace in terms of that.
Like, naturally, I just want to give people hugs and like walk up like, hey, what's up? And it's been really weird. Like, it's been really awkward. And people that are used to me doing that every single day are like, what's wrong with Q? He doesn't want to, like, you know what I mean? Doesn't want to give me a hug today?
I'm a public health specialist, and I am confident we can change the way we show we care. We can do kind things that are not about engaging physically. And it's important for us to recognize that how we feel we are loved is not necessarily how another person feels that they are loved. And it's different for all of us. And that's what we need to respect.
Overall, I think the experience was kind of cool. It was kind of hard not being able to touch people all day or get hugs or my usual thing, you know, but I think the idea is really cool. I think for Emily, she probably really into it, is for sure.
Touch can harm in both mental and physical ways. And I think it's really important that people's personal space is respected at all times.